Many of you have requested a video about prostate stones. Are they common? How do they form? Why do they form? What are the related symptoms? How can they be treated? My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. Prostate stones are extremely common. However, the exact percentage of men with prostate calcifications is unclear. According to some studies, it is as high as 86%, while other publications report it to be as low as roughly 7%. According to my experience, the formation of prostate stones is clearly age-related. In the older male above 60 years, they are kind of a standard finding, definitely closer to 86% than to 7%. Why and how do they form? The most widely accepted mechanism is connected to urinary reflux within the prostate. This usually happens when the free flow of urine from the bladder is hampered. A possible reason could be a urethral stricture. If you don't know what that is, watch this video. Or it could be an enlarged prostate that's blocking the passage. So urine gets into the prostate, we call this reflux. As a result, there will be deposition of hydroxyapatite crystallites from the urine within the small ducts of the prostate. In a chemical reaction with calcium, minerals are formed, also known as prostate stones. These minerals block and dilate the small ducts of the prostate, which worsens the problem. The prostate may react with inflammation, which in turn could drive benign prostatic enlargement. I have uploaded several videos about this. The inflammation leads to the benign multiplication of cells. It is not a swelling. It's a very important fact to remember. Patients often express concern about prostate stones. However, urologists typically do not view them as a major issue. Academically, I mean, if we are talking urology in the ivory tower, one classifies prostate stones into four groups according to their structure in electron microscopy. But this will lead to four, I won't go into detail here. When I see calcifications in the prostate, I usually don't think much. I mostly find them upon transrectal ultrasound within or at the boundaries of an enlarged central zone. As I said, this is almost the standard appearance of an aging prostate. Prostate stones are not a sign of cancer. They don't increase your risk for cancer either. However, there is some data showing a weak correlation between prostate cancer and calcifications in the peripheral zone. But generally, I would like to conclude that I don't automatically think prostate cancer when I see prostatic calcifications. If you want to know what a correlation is and what it means, watch this video. As a rule, prostate stones don't give you any symptoms. So if you are diagnosed with prostate stones, there is nothing to worry about. You won't feel a thing. There are some studies connecting lower urinary tract symptoms, such as weak stream, urgency, hesitancy, nocturia, and so on, with prostate stones. There has even been a discussion whether they are related to chronic pelvic pain. This is all very vague though. So this means, since they don't give symptoms and since we urologists for the time being think prostate stones don't mean anything, we don't treat them as a rule. Under special and individual circumstances like severe obstruction, treatment could be warranted. Treatment is always surgical. Usually it is done transurethrally with a small instrument that is inserted into the urethra under anesthesia. One would then cut off parts of the prostate from the inside. This is called resection. During this procedure, the stones are removed. Hope that clarifies things a bit. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.